recent laws passed by the Indian Parliament are set to irrevocably damage Indian democracy and constitutional framework. In August 2019, government revoked the autonomy of the provinces of Jammu and Kashmir. Phone and internet is cut off there since then. Key political leaders are detained. This paves the way for Hindu Indian settlements in Kashmir to change the demographic setup of the region. Since its inception, Israel has used Jewish-only settlements to supplant local Palestinian communities that are being expelled from their land. India's new citizenship law grants minorities from neighboring countries citizenship as long as they are not Muslim. Even Rohingyas from the neighboring Myanmar are excluded in the law. The law of return, a central pillar of Israel's apartheid regime, grants only Jews citizenship but bars even Palestinian refugees the right to return. India is preparing a national register of citizenship requiring, especially from non-Hindus, documents to prove ancestral connection to what is India today. Colonization of land and exclusion and expulsion of Palestinians are fundamental pillars of Israel's apartheid regime that are now being emulated by Modi's far-right government, subverting India's legacy as a secular democracy. This undermines the very essence of India's pluralist identity. This ideological affinity between Modi's Hindutva government and Israel deepens material ties that prop up Israel's oppression of the Palestinian people. India is the biggest buyer of Israeli weapons. Agriculture, universities and Bollywood have become testing grounds and propaganda spaces for Israel. Our oppressors are connected, but our movements united can defeat them. The growing resistance against Israeli apartheid and Indian Hindutva unites Palestinians, Kashmiris and Indians. We stand together for freedom, justice and equality.